بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. عم يتساءلون عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم انفعنا بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة يا أرحم الراحمين. وبعد، we come to the end. ختامه مسك, the fragrance with a fragrant seal, which is جزء عما, the 30th and the last جزء of the Quran. Where because the Qur'an, as you move through the journey of the Qur'an, you start with longer surahs and they become shorter and shorter until we come to the end where we go through the shorter surahs of the Qur'an, which is why just 30 has 37 surahs within it, the vast majority of which were surahs revealed in Mecca. Surah An-Nasr at the end, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ, by agreement was revealed in Mecca. But then there are other surahs like Surah Al الإخلاص فلق الناس, about which there's some discussion as to whether they were revealed in Mecca or Medina. Surah An-Nasr being revealed in Medina by agreement. So when we look at these surahs, we just quickly move through these surahs. We begin with Surah An-Naba, عَمَّ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the Day of Judgment, the question that they discuss in the Day of Judgment. He then speaks about different aspects of creation. أَلَمْ نَجَعَلِ الْأَرْضَ مِهَادٍ, speaks about the earth, and he speaks about the night, he speaks about the day. All of these are proofs of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then describes hellfire. And perhaps the hardest verse against the unbelievers in description of hellfire comes in Surah عَمَّ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, فَذُوقُوا فَلَنْ نَزِيدَكُمْ إِلَّا عَذَابًا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to the unbelievers by saying, I taste the filth, the liquid that they required to drink inside of hellfire, because we will only ever increase you in punishment. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gives a description of paradise, followed by at the end a statement of the unbelievers, how they will be on that day, when all of the unbelievers will say, Ya laytani kuntu turaba, oh woe to me if only I had been soil. If only I had never existed. Surah An-Nazi'at, after that, speaks about a similar theme. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by angels that the Day of Judgment is absolutely real, that they will come, the blowing of the trumpet, تَتْبَعُهَا الرَّادِفَة, which will be followed by a second blowing for resurrection, when all of human beings, بِالسَّاهِرَة, they will all be brought out on open plains. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then reminds, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى, has not the story of Musa عليه السلام come to you? With Fir'aun, Pharaoh, he denied, and he went to the extremes of denial, where he claimed, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى, I am your Lord, the Most High. But despite that, he was still destroyed. He was still, and he will likewise be resurrected, and he'll be led into hellfire, as the Qur'an states, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَعِبْرَةٌ لِمَنْ يَخْشَى, there's a lesson for that in those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah An-Nazi'at then speaks about creation, again to remind people about the day of judgment, and to show how insignificant the creation of human beings is. And then the surah ends by speaking about the very moment when the trumpet will be blown. This is then followed by Surah Abasa wa Tawalla. Surah Abasa, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first speaks to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the responsibility of calling, and how his responsibility is not just to call the leaders of kufr, but to concern himself with those who desire to purify themselves and wish to be raised closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Abasa then speaks about the ungratefulness of human beings. قُتِلَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا أَكْفَرَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about, may the human be killed. مَا أَكْفَرَ, what is it that makes him deny? reminding him of how he's created, reminding him of how he'll die, reminding him about the very food that he has. فَلْيَنْظُرُ الْإِنسَانُ إِلَى طَعَامِهِ. How everything was taken care of by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How human beings are ungrateful to against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds about the terrifying moments of the day when nobody can help, when a man will flee from his brother, from his wife, from his father, from his mother, from his children. Nobody will be able to help each other on that day. Surah At-Takwir, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ, likewise speaks about the Day of Judgment, but speaks about the changes that precede the Day of Judgment, when the sun no longer burns, when the moons disappear, when wild beasts are gathered together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in detail about events that will occur at the moments of when the trumpet is to be blown and when the next will be resurrected. But then after speaking and then after describing all of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا أَحْضَرَتْ. On that day, every soul will know what it sent forth for the next world. The rest of that surah, brief surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then speaks about the absolute truthfulness of the revelation, speaking about Jibreel alayhi salam being truthful, speaking about the Quran being truthful, speaking about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being truthful. إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلُ رَسُولُ. This is a word of a noble messenger, Jibreel alayhi salam. وَمَا صَاحِبُكُمْ بِمَجْنُونَ. Your companion Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who lived with you for over 40 years before he came with this message, he was never crazy. Surah Al-Infitar, إِذَا السَّمَاءُ انْفَطَرَتْ, similar message, beginning with, in a briefer manner, beginning with the themes or events that precede the end, وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْثِرَتْ, when the graves will be opened up, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخْرَتْ, every soul will know what it's done and what it's not done. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to every single human being, مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. O human being, what's deluded you about your noble Lord, the one who created, the one who fashioned you, and yet still you deny resurrection. You still deny resurrection. Every single thing that you're doing, there are angels on either side, kiram and katibin, noble scribes who are recording everything that you do. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the absolute truth of the Day of Judgment, where he ends by saying, we're asking about وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ ثُمَّمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْءٍ. On that day, no soul has the ability to do anything for anyone. وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ. And the affair is completely with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then follows Surah Al-Mutaffifin. Surah Al-Mutaffifin. Again, a surah about the Day of Judgment, but interesting way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins, where he condemns those who cheat in their tradings, in their business trading with the people. Those who, when they buy something, they will always try and get more than what they're entitled to. But when they sell something, they will always shortchange the person that they're selling to. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemns that practice of cheating, and by extension, all wrong practices, by saying, أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمِ الْعَظِيمِ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Do these people not realize that they're going to be resurrected on a day when all of humanity will stand in front of the Lord of all of the worlds? Then Allah speaks about the difference between the sinners, those who denied, those whose records are kept in Sijjin. The records are known as Sijjin, where everything that they've done is recorded. Those will be denied, from veiled from gazing at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on that day. And all of that because rana ala qulubihim, because rust entered onto their hearts because of all the sins that they did. At the opposite side, you have al-illiyin, al-abrar, the righteous, those who do good, whose record is known as illiyin, where the highest of angels, they gaze at their records, and such people, they have the greatest of all rewards when they will drink the waters of paradise, khitamuhu misk. After they finish drinking, there will be a fragrance of musk on their mouths, and that's a water, or that's a drink that's mixed with waters from a river in paradise known as Tasneem, which is exclusively for the righteous slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Mutaffifin ends where Allah just reminds the believers to pay no attention to the ridicule and the mocking that the unbelievers, they do towards the believers in this world, because roles will be reversed in that world, and at that time, the believers will mock and ridicule those who are destined to eternal punishment and hellfire. Then you have Surah Al-Inshiqaq, the Sama Unshaqqat, again speaking about the changes that precede the Day of Judgment, reminding people of their different destinations, people who are destined to hellfire, who again they laugh and they joke about believers, but the believers will have the upper hand. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ends the surah by swearing an oath about the truth of the Quran, and warns that the unbelievers ultimately will never accept this message. Then comes Surah Al-Buruj. Surah Al-Buruj speaks about the struggle between believers and unbelievers. Ashab al-Ukhdud, the people of the ditch who were flung into ditches of fire, which actually happened in the Yemen. In the Yemen, people who believed in the truth of Isa alayhi salam were punished, and they were thrown into ditches that were lit with fire. Allah speaks about the struggles of believers and unbelievers, eternal struggle that's always been there. But then the revenge comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The forceful, powerful revenge. Inna batasha rabbika la shadeed. Innahu huwa yubdi'u wa yu'eed. Where Allah subhanahu speaks about the forceful, powerful nature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fa'alun lima yureed. Who does whatever he wants. The surah ends where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the Quran. Bal huwa Quranun majeed fi lawhin mahfooz. That this is all contained within a majestic Quran, which is all inside of a guarded, preserved tablet. So everything that's contained within this message is absolutely true from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah Al-Buruj is then followed by Surah Al-Tariq, and Surah Al-Tariq is a surah that speaks where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds people about their lowly origin. Mimma in dafiq, you came from sperm that gushes out. And then just to remind that if that's your origin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will undoubtedly recreate on a day where everything, all secrets will be laid out and nothing will be hidden, and absolute power is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The surah ends by letting us know innahu laqawlun fasl, that this Quran is a decisive word. It's absolutely true and it clarifies these matters. Wama huwa bil hazl, it's not something that's a joke. It's not amusement, it's not something that's lighthearted. And tells the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam just to leave the unbelievers be as they are, give them respite, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with them. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, malikin nas, ilahin nas, min شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ.